Hi friends, welcome to Divakar and Sons Tutorials. This is Gurunath Divakar. And friends, today we are going to start the next concept in the topic life process. Friends, in our previous video we have studied already about life process and living and non-living things, the difference between living and non-living things and the process of the living organisms to maintain their life on the earth, how much those processes are important to maintain their body, their life on the earth. All these things we have studied, and we have studied already the first process, nutrition. In nutrition, we have studied two types of nutritions are there, autotrophic and heterotrophic. Friends, we know that autotrophic nutrition is that nutrition in which the organisms, living organisms, prepared their food themselves. Auto means themselves, self. And in heterotrophic nutrition, we have studied that in this nutrition, in this mode of nutrition, the organisms which are depend for their food on other organisms. Maybe those other organisms may be autotrophic or heterotrophic. But the heterotrophic organisms always depend for their food on other organisms. This type of nutrition having organisms, we are calling them it as heterotrophic, and self preparing food organisms are autotrophic. So we are going to study the next concept, the next part of the life process chapter. Okay. So details of autotrophic organisms we have studied already. Now we are going to deep in heterotrophic nutrition organisms. So in heterotrophic nutrition organisms, we can divide them as three parts. First one is saprotrophic nutrition, and second one is parasitic nutrition, and third one is halozoic nutrition. So these three nutritions are there in heterotrophic nutritions. Mind friends, what are heterotrophic nutritions? Those organisms which depend for their food on the other organisms. Means all these three types of organisms should be depend for their food on other organisms. But this dependency is different between these three organisms. Then what is that difference? We are going to study in this topic, in this video. Okay friends, now we are going to study the saprotrophic nutrition, which is the first part in heterotrophic nutrition. So sapro means it is dead. So what is the definition of saprotrophic? Saprophytes means the organisms which are having saprotrophic nutrition, those organisms are called as saprophytes. So saprophytes are the organisms which obtain their food from dead plants. Dead plants are dead and decaying animals' bodies and other decaying organic matter like rotten bread. So this is the definition for saprotrophic nutrition organisms, means for saprophytes. So let us understand the definition. When we understand the definition, think that we understand detail about the organisms. First, see here, saprophytes are the organisms which obtain their food from dead plants. So when the plants become dead, from that plants which are getting food, those organisms are called saprotrophic organisms or saprophytes. Not only this one, and also they will get their food from dead and decaying animals. When the animals become dead, it may be human being or it may be animals, when it becomes dead, after some time it will start decaying. All of you know that when that organisms start decaying, this decayed body of the dead organisms is the food for saprotrophic nutrition organisms. Means there they are going to be develop their life. First one, from dead plants and dead and decaying animals, and also they are decaying organic matter like rotten bread. Organic matter means what? Which are the food materials of the human beings or organisms, living organisms, food materials. When that food material become decaying, rotten, for example bread, when it becomes rotten, there you will be find some plants, some organisms are growing up on that bread. So those organisms depend for their food on that decayed or rotten bread or decaying plant's body or the dead plants. So they will be take food from that body, and then they will maintain their life on the earth. So this type, for example, for this type bread molds, the white material you will find from the rotten bread, those are called bread molds. They are saprotrophic nutrition organisms. And mushrooms, you will be seen in the on the road, when it is a rainy season, you will be seen some mushrooms like a white colored mushrooms you will be find on the road or on the dead plants you will be find. So those type umbrella like structures trees you will be find on the road in the rainy season. So those are called mushrooms and yeast. And also many bacteria, not all bacterias, there are different types of bacterias are there. In those, some bacterias are taking food as a saprotrophic nutrition, saprotrophic mode, some bacterias. Other bacterias I will tell you later. So in those bacterias, some bacterias are having the mode of nutrition as saprotrophic nutrition. So next we come to the next part, that is parasitic nutrition. The organisms having parasitic mode of nutrition, those organisms are called as parasites. The name of the organisms is parasites. The name of the mode is parasitic nutrition mode. So let us study the definition of that parasitic nutrition organisms. The nutrition in which an organism derives its food from the body of another living organism host without killing it is called parasitic nutrition. Friends, are you understand the definition? This type of organisms are also dependent for their food on the other organisms, but the dependency is different here. What is in first type saprotrophic nutritions, they have depend on the dead plants, dead animals and rotten breads. But here the nutrition in which an organism derives its food from the body of another living organisms. See here, in saprotrophic they are depending on the dead plants, dead animals and rotten breads. So but here this parasitic nutrition mode organisms are depends for their food on the living organisms. That is the main difference here. This parasitic nutritions are depend on the living organisms. Saprotrophic are depend on the dead plants and dead animals and rotten organic materials, but here these are depends on living organisms. And the next word come here, host. Host is nothing but those organisms, these parasitic organisms depend their food on living organisms, isn't it? If you say A is a parasitic organism, A depends for its food on the B, which is a living organism. So this B, what is this living organism, is called host of the A. B is a host of A. If man is the living organism and this parasitic organisms are depend on this man, then that man is called host of that parasitic organism. You understand, friends? Host is the parasitic organisms which depend on the living organism. That living organism is called a host. So like that, see the definition now. You will now understand the definition. The nutrition in which an organism derives means depends or derives its food from the body of another living organism. That another living organism is called host. Without killing it, see, when it depends on living organism, it will not kill that host. If it kills that host, then it is impossible to the parasitic organisms to depend on that body, because they are not depending on the dead animals. They are only depending on the living animals. So because of that, they are not going to be kill the organisms which they are depending. They are not going to be killed. They remains in their body and they are taking food from that body, but they are not killing that body. For example, roundworms, they are living in our body, but they are not killing us. Like that, without killing it means the host. This parasitic organisms not kill the host is called parasitic nutrition. You understand, friends? When the parasitic nutrition depends on the living organisms, that living organisms is called as hosts, and this parasitic organism is not going to be kill that host. It remains in that body and it derives its food from that body, but it not kills. But remember, friends, it will not help to that body also. The parasitic organisms are not going to be help to that host, but it injuries to that body. It harms that body. They are not helping that body. They are not improving that body. Those parasitic mode of nutrition organisms harms the host. Harms it. All fevers in human beings, all fevers are by the parasitic nutrition mode of organisms only. The viral fevers, virus, you have heard the name virus. What are those virus? Those virus are parasitic nutrition organisms, means parasites. Those organisms, virus, are parasites. They are living in our body. They are taking their food from that body. But they are not helping to that body, but it harms that body. because we will get fever, we will get unsatisfaction. When they are in our body, we will be unhealthy because they are driving their foods from our body. They are taking our food for themselves. Because of that, we have become weak. We have become unsatisfactory, unhealthy. We call it as fever. So these all the virus. See here. Host, the definition of host. Host are those living organism from which parasites receives food. That's all I have explained. When they receive the food from other organism, those other organism is called as host. So example for parasitic, several fungi. So these fungi are in the body of the or living organisms, and they are driving their food from that living organisms. And bacteria, see there, we have explained about the bacteria in saprotrophic organisms also. On the dead organism, on the dead body of the plants and dead body of the animals also, they depend. So there I have told that some type of bacterias and other type of bacterias are parasites. They depends on the living organisms. Those bacteria are harmful to our body, and they will become us if unhealthy. So all fevers are viral fevers are because of parasitic node of nutrition organisms or parasites. Okay friends, so next come to the next type of nutrition, that is holozoic nutrition. See friends, in heterotopic I have told that the organisms depend on the other organisms for their food. So in that type of organisms, three types we have studied, we are going to be study in those three. First two types are those types. First type of organisms are depend on the dead animals and dead plants, and second type is depend on the living organisms. Let us know what type of third organisms are. The nutrition in which an organism takes the complex organic food materials into its body. See friends, here we are not saying dead animals or dead plants or living organisms, nothing but those organisms which are taking complex food. For example, I have explained starch from the plants. Autotrophic plants, autotrophic organisms prepare their food. They will be stock that prepared food as a starch in their body. For example, green plants, they are reserving those prepared foods in their body as a starch. I have explained it, which is very complicated structure. So those type of foods the organisms takes it, the complicated food materials they will take inside. The nutrition in which an organism takes the complex organic food. See, it is not inorganic food, it's a organic food. For example, starch. Plants make organic food from inorganic materials. They will take inorganic materials like carbon dioxide, sunlight, and water. They will take inorganic materials and they will be convert them into organic materials like hydrocarbon. In that hydrocarbon, the model is starch. Those complicated structured starch, that is organic food materials into its body, complex organic food materials, starch, body by the process of egation. Egation means what? For example, see, human being are taking their food when you take the food, you will directly take it into the stomach? No. You will make it a small pieces. So this type of taking food, we are calling it as egation. So body, by the process of egation, complex type foods, those will take into the body by egation. The egested food is digested. This egested food goes into the stomach. There it will be digested. It will digested and then absorbed into the body cells. From there, when it digested into a simple organic material, then with the help of blood, it will be transferred to the cells. Those cells absorb that food and make it as a food for living in the body. So they will absorb their food. So complicated structure food enters into the body of the organisms by egested. Then it will become digested. That digested food absorbed by the cells. And that absorbed food extract the wasted out of the body. This type of nutrition organisms are called holozoic organisms. Holozoic organisms. Can you tell me, friends, the example for holozoic? Exactly, human being. Human being, or all human beings are holozoic organisms, and also some type of animals. Dog, cat, rat, tiger, deer. All these type of animals are holozoic. So see, friends, in human being, vegetarian are also, non-vegetarian are also there. So whatever they may be, vegetarian and non-vegetarian, they will take their food which is complicated in structure. If you take the example of vegetables, they are taking food from the vegetables. In vegetables, what are the food? It is a starch. So it is complicated. And the others, for example, tiger, they are taking their food from the animals. So on the animals, those animals, all the body of that animals is a complicated structure. It is having in a form of a cell. That organ, that food, they will be take inside and ingest that food. And that ingested food goes into the stomach. There it become digest. That digested food is now converted into a simple organic material. Those organic materials are going to be supplied to the cells. Those cells absorb the food, simple food, and make them as a food for that their process. So this type of organisms, we are calling them as holozoic nutrition organisms. And the examples are human beings and some animals are the example for this type of organisms. So are you understand, friends, living and non-living things? In living and non-living things, living things are, should be, they have some life processes to alive on the earth. On those life processes, what are the life processes? Nutrition, respiration, digestion, transportation, excretion. These are the life process of the living organisms. So in these life process, we have taken nutrition. So in nutrition, we have observed, friends, in the holozoic nutrition, I am explaining this. In this nutrition, when we take the food, it will be ingested, digested, transferred, and absorbed. See there, some processes are here. This nutrition, when it should be complete. To complete that process, there should be need other processes are also. Transportation, digestion, excretion, All these processes, we are taking examples here, which are necessary to the living organisms. So those food, so those type of processes, we are calling it as necessary for the living organisms. So those processes, in those two processes, we are studying about the nutrition. In that nutrition, I have explained already what is the nutrient. This nutrient, taking of nutrient is called nutrition. And this nutrition is for two types. One is for energy, another is for biosynthesis. So energy means to work. We need some energy. So for that energy, we are using that food, that nutrition. In other, to grow up, to develop our body muscles, and other, all these biological processes, we are using that food, that is called biosynthesis. So for these two purposes, we are, the living organisms are using that food. So this food, when we are taking, this is called nutrition. In this nutrition, nothing but the taking of food from the environment. In this, we have divided into two types. First one is autotrophic, which are preparing their food themselves. And heterotrophic, which are depends on the other organisms for their food. So in autotrophic, we have studied all the green plants are preparing their food by the photosynthesis. By the method of photosynthesis, they are preparing their own food. But the other organisms, living organisms, which are moving on the earth, those organisms depends for their food on the other organisms. So in dependency, there is three types. First type, the organisms which are depend on the dead plants and dead animals and decay bread, those animals. And second one is which are depend on the living organisms, but they are not going to be kill that host, but it harms that host, that type of organisms. And the third type of organisms are those organisms which are taking complicated food from the environment, and it will be ingested and digested, converted into a simple form, and those simple form transfers to all the cells in the body, and those cells absorb that food. This method, we are calling it as third part of the organisms, that is halozoic organism, nutrition having organisms. Okay friend, you understand the difference of the organisms? Now in next video, we are going to study what is photosynthesis. In autotrophic organisms, that is green plants, how they are preparing their food, what we are calling it as, we are named it as photosynthesis. What is actually process in the photosynthesis? How the food is, glucose is preparing in photosynthesis? What are the parts of the plants are helping to prepare their food? All these things we are going to study in our next video, friends. Are you understand? Are you feel it is like just like a game? Simple. Biology is also just like a game. When we are studying systematically and step by step, it is very easy to understand and also is very easy to remember. Okay, friends. So, okay, we will meet in the next video. And for that, before that, I am requesting you people, please press the bell button and like the video if you are able to understand my explanation. This is because I have to meet you people again, and more peoples I have to reach. For that, please like it and press the bell button. Okay, friends. Bye. See you.